and it's not working out. What's up, y'all? It's KeitahSimone here, and this is my first YouTube video for my new YouTube channel, so make sure you subscribe, like, and comment down below. And as you can see from the title of this video, I'm going to be doing a get to know me tag. So I asked my Instagram to drop a few questions for me for you guys to get to know me a little better before getting into my YouTube channel, so you know who I am, know what I do, all that good stuff. So without further ado, let's get right into it. So the first question is, what's my full name? My full name is KeitahSimone Andrews. So that's where I got my YouTube channel, my first and middle name. It's also the same name as my Instagram, YouTube, Twitter, all that. So yeah, KeitahSimone. I honestly don't know what my name means. I was named after my aunt. So I tried looking it up, but because of my spelling, it's very unique, therefore it never pops up. I try, you know, the little Urban Dictionary definitions. None of that really works. So I don't really know what my name means. I might learn one day. What's my age? I am 19. Sometimes I don't look like it because of my height, but I'm 19. I just turned 19 a couple weeks ago, and yeah. When's my birthday? Like I just said a couple weeks ago, it's January 15th, 2002. And what is my zodiac sign? My zodiac sign is a Capricorn. Best zodiac sign out here. Can't argue with that. How tall are you? I'm 4'11 and 3/4. Everybody says those 3/4 don't matter, but they do. Trust me, they do. I'm 4'11. I'm very short, but I get it from my father. So, yeah. How many siblings do you have? I have 8 siblings. I have 5 sisters and 3 brothers. And yes, I'm the youngest of 9. I am very much spoiled. I hate to admit it, but I am. How many kids do you want in the future? Honestly, because I have so many nieces and nephews, they remind me every day that I don't want kids, but deep down inside, I do want kids. But honestly, I don't know how many kids I want. Because I've grown up in a big family, I definitely don't want a big family of my own. So maybe 2 or 3, but I don't think I'm pushing out anymore after that. Cause no. What are some of your goals? Honestly, my biggest goal, well, I'm gonna start with short-term goals. So most of the stuff that I did as my New Year's resolutions is like being more confident, because I'm not outspoken at all. Granted, you don't have to be in this world, but like, I don't really like the way I don't really like how shy I am. So I'm gonna try to get more, not honestly, I want to say more confident, because I'm very confident in myself, but just more out there and not being as shy as I am, because not that it's not gonna get me nowhere in life, but what's the fun of being shy when you could be out there? And I feel like I could gain more friends and stuff by being outspoken. And also, I'm going to need that for networking and stuff like that, finding a job. And I can't always be shy and not knowing what to say and wanting to keep my mouth closed or not speaking unless spoken to. Like, that's not going to get me nowhere. So that's my first goal, is to be more outspoken. Another goal is, I definitely want to focus on me a lot more this year. I do already, but not as much as I should. So I would like to work on, you know, doing my skincare routine every day, working out, getting my body right, all that. Like, not really worrying about everything that's going out. Not everything that's going out in the world, because obviously I need that. But like, all the drama and like social media and stuff like that, I don't want to be too into that. I want to focus more on myself. Another goal is honestly just succeeding through college right now, because it is very hard and I definitely don't want to give up. And yeah, I just want to be able to get good grades, academically succeed, all that. So that's another one of my goals for the year, is to stay focused and succeed. Short term, I think that's it. In terms of long term, I definitely want to be successful. Want to be able to make my own money, live on my own, be able to do all that myself. Nice car, nice house. So yeah. What's my favorite color? Honestly, I've always had a whole bunch of different colors, but once I decorated my dorm room for the fall semester, me and my roommate and I, we chose the colors baby blue. And after buying everything I needed for my room, I fell in love with the color. My nails were baby blue. I had a phone case that was baby blue, all that. So my favorite color as of right now is definitely baby blue, but I don't wear it a lot. The main color I wear is black. I don't own that many colors. I really should though, because when I do wear those colors, I actually really look really good. So I don't want to always wear black, but yeah, my favorite color is baby blue. What made you start YouTube? Honestly, during the break of after my fall semester, during winter break, I did nothing. If I wasn't out with my friends, I was in the bed watching TV. And after a while, I started not liking that, because I don't want to be a couch potato all my life. No, I felt really lazy and I wasn't doing anything. But also, I feel like me doing YouTube and working on my personality, I feel like it's also going to help me be more outspoken like I want to, and help me grow as being more confident in myself in terms of like speaking out and stuff like that. So I definitely feel like it's going to make me a little more outgoing. So that's the main reason why I wanted to start YouTube. And honestly, I'm always on YouTube and watching everybody else make YouTube videos. It's like, it looks like a lot of fun and I want to try it myself. And I don't really have anything that's just me and something that I do. So now we're here. That's why I want to start a YouTube channel. And honestly, I've been thinking about it for a while, but I never really actually started it. But today, I'm starting it. Let's see. Where do you go to school and what are you studying? I currently go to Montclair State University. It's an amazing school, honestly. It was my top school when I applied. And what I'm studying exercise science. And no, that doesn't mean like, oh, I want to be a personal trainer, or oh, you want to be a gym teacher. Every time somebody hears exercise science, that's what they think. But no, it's more terms of athletic training and stuff like that. So after college and after I finish studying exercise science, I want to be an athletic trainer. Honestly, I took interest in the athletic trainers at my school because I was a cheerleader. So therefore, I had a front row seat of everything that the athletic trainers at our school did in terms of like being the first ones there when somebody gets injured on a football field or like on a basketball court, and being the first one to respond to them. And honestly, I liked how I would be the first person that can help them out, and I'm right there on the spot for them when they need me, and I'm the one who takes care of them before they get to the hospital. So I feel like being able to at least do something to a certain extent to where what my job allows me to do to help an injured player, I took a lot of interest in that. And also, I have a lot of interest in sports because I was a cheerleader, so I was always around sports. And being able to be on that field or on that court with the players and having that connection that all the players and stuff at my school had with our athletic trainers, I really want that. So yeah, I want to become an athletic trainer. And yeah, it just seems like not only does it seem like a really cool job, it's a very good job. They pay well, and I could get my name out there a lot, and I might even be able to become one of the main athletic trainers that like the NFL wants, or the NBA, or anybody. Honestly, I'm more focused on basketball and football, but if any other sport needs me, I'm going obviously going to be there. But athletic training and physical therapy, yes, they have a lot of connections and a lot of similarities, but they are definitely completely different, because physical therapy is like their road to recovery and to after an injury. But like me, I'm there with them, like do practices and stuff like that, and like whatever the physical therapist tell them they're able to come back and do, I now have to assess them to make sure I know that that's what they could do and they're ready to come back onto the field. So yeah, I think that's going to be a lot of fun. Next question. What are your favorite places to shop for clothes? I'm a shopaholic. I'm gonna start off with that. So that's all I do. My favorite places to shop, I shop more online because it's just easier and I like to stay in my bed and the click of a button I could do. So I personally shop at Fashion Nova a lot. Shein, Pretty Little Thing, all those Misguided, all those online apps or websites that are famous and everybody knows about, that's my favorite. But like when I go to the mall, I definitely like going to Foot Locker, Forever 21, things of that sort, Zumiez. Those are honestly all the stores I go to, but if I had to choose, my favorite would be like Fashion Nova and Foot Locker. Favorite sneaker brand? My favorite sneaker brand is Jordan, definitely. I don't have that many, but I love Jordans. I don't like every Jordans, but majority of them I like. But yeah, Jordans is my favorite. Favorite season? I love fall. Not only do I love fall because it's obviously football season, but it's also the whole weather. That's my favorite time to dress, honestly. And I love how it's not too cold, but it's not hot either. It's just like right in the middle. I don't need that many clothes. So yeah, sweater weather, favorite. Favorite sport? My favorite sport to play is cheerleading, even though you don't play cheerleading, but yes, cheerleading is a sport. And I could make a YouTube video arguing that cheerleading is definitely a sport, because it is. But that's my favorite sport to participate in. But my favorite sport to watch is definitely football. And I think that plays a part in the fact that I was a cheerleader for football. And that was the main thing I had in front of me. But yeah, football is definitely my favorite. My favorite hobby as of right now is dancing. Hopefully YouTube becomes my favorite hobby. But dancing, I love to dance. If I'm not cheerleading, I'm dancing. So yeah. My favorite hobby. And listening to music. Like, I love music. I don't think I could go in the world without music, because no. Music is everything. I do it. I listen to music with everything I do. Homework, cleaning. If I'm just sitting there, I always have my headphones in listening to music. Favorite high school moment. Honestly, my favorite high school moments, but definitely football season. Definitely, I'm saying it a lot, but that was my favorite. Like Friday Night Lights, favorite part of high school. I was so excited in eighth grade and in middle school. I was so excited to be a part of that. And once I got to high school, it's the best thing. Trust me. Like, if your school didn't have that, I'm sorry, but Friday Night Lights was definitely it, because it's just like, it's so much going on at once. It's just so much fun. Like the football team, the dance team, the cheerleaders, the band, the fans. Like everything is just, it's just a vibe. The bright lights, everybody's cheering, like best thing in the world. So definitely cheerleading season was my favorite high school moment. But I also was in the dance program, so I loved dancing too. But like, I can't really think of a specific favorite high school moment, because it's been a lot. But yeah, football season, Friday Night Lights. That was my favorite. Have you been out the country? If so, where? Yes and no. Like, I've never went somewhere. I'm touching my hair a lot, but my bad. But I've never been somewhere, like, I've never gone to, like, Bora Bora and stayed for a long period of time. Like, the only thing I've done was I've been on a cruise, and that weekend we were on a cruise for, we went to 3 different islands. So we went to Turks and Caicos, Puerto Rico, and Dominican Republic. I only stayed for one day each time. So, like, Friday was Grand Turk, Turks and Caicos, and then Saturday was Puerto Rico, and then Sunday was Dominican Republic. And we only spent a few hours there, but yes, I can say I've been out the country, technically. I didn't need a passport, so not really, but I've been to those 3 places, and they are gorgeous. The heat, I cannot do, but beautiful islands. Like, the water is just clear. The culture of each place is just beautiful. Like, I took so many pictures. I felt like I was a photographer. My favorite animal. My best friend laughs at me for having this be my favorite animal, because she's always like, why is that your favorite animal? Like, who just likes those? But elephants are my favorite animal. Like, I love elephants so much. If I get the chance to ride one day, I'm going to be happy. Like, they're just like, if I'm not mistaken, they're a sign of good luck, if I heard that correctly. But not only that, they're just so cute. Like, if you give me a stuffed animal, I want it to be an elephant. Like, I want an elephant tatted. I want a tattoo of an elephant. Like, all of that. That is my favorite animal. Drop your favorite fit. I get dressed a lot, so that's going to be hard to choose. But it's going to be right here. I'm going to drop it right here for y'all. That's definitely my favorite fit out of them all, because I look good. What was your longest relationship? I believe it was like a year. It definitely was a year, but I believe it was a year and a few months. However, like, we broke up and we weren't dating anymore, but we were still on and off in terms of, like, still in each other's lives for a couple more years after that. But technically speaking, we dated for like a year and a few months. But yeah, it was a relationship from like, the year and a few months was 8th grade into freshman. And then after freshman year, we broke up. But then sophomore and junior year, we were still kind of like in each other's lives and dealing with each other still, but never really like in a relationship. But technically speaking, we were still messing with each other and dealing with each other sophomore and junior year. But then after that, no. And then that was my only relationship. So I only had one relationship. So yeah, a year and a month, I believe. So yeah, I believe that's all the questions, to be honest with you. Let me just make sure. My favorite quote. I don't really have a personal favorite because I love quotes, but like, the biggest thing I live by, I would say, is, honestly, I don't remember who's by. I'll look it up. But it's, whether you think you can or you can't, you're right. And I think that's a really good quote to live by, because what it's saying is, if you think you can't do it, then you're not going to be able to do it if you keep telling yourself you can't. But if you really know and believe that you can, you're going to be able to do it. And yeah, I just like how, whether you think you can or you can't, you're right. So yeah, I would have to say that's my favorite quote to live by. I skipped one. Are you single or taken? I am currently single, ready to mingle. But yeah, I'm single as of right now. I'm not in a relationship or talking to anybody right now. Like I said in the beginning, I'm trying to really focus on myself before I even put myself out there to get into another relationship and stuff like that. So yeah, I'm single. All right, so this is the end of my video. Hope you guys got to know me a lot more and better before you got into my YouTube channel. So hopefully you guys stay after this video. Be on the lookout for clothing hauls, vlogs, pranks possibly, and a whole lot more. I'm really excited to start this YouTube channel because who wouldn't be? But yeah, that's me, KeitahSimone. And make sure you like and comment down below, subscribe to my channel, and put on the post notifications so you know every time I post a new video. I will see y'all again in the next video.